transportation means whatever fluid particles, especially in our body, so which can be transferred to the one part of the body to another part of the body. So that is defined as the transportation. So maybe especially it can be called as the blood. So it is one of the important components which can be transferred to all parts of our body. So they can be carried the oxygen from the one part of the cell to another part of the cells, and also they can be the release whatever nutrients are there, they can be absorbed from the blood. Is it? So like that, blood vessels also are one of the important component of the transportation system. Like they are consist of the atrium and also ventricles. Is it? So they will carry the oxygenated blood and also by whatever deoxygenated blood which is collected from the cells that can be released into the lungs also. So this is the role of the arteries and veins. So likewise, if you come across the heart, heart is one of the pumping organ which can be the all the parts of whatever we have to the blood is in our body, that should be the transferred to the all the parts of our body. So they will be released, they can be transferred the hemoglobin from the one part of the cell to another part of the cell. So what is the main function of the heart means? The heart is one of the pumping organ which can be circulated the blood to all over the body with the help of the veins and arteries. So generally arteries are the thick walls and veins are the thin walls. So these are the some function of the heart. So next of all we can be seen to the transportation in plants. So these are all we can be study about in the animals. So next we can be seen to the transportation in plants. So we know that plants have also some transportation system. So we have the cells, tissues, organ and organ system. But in our plants, they are restricted only in the tissues. Yes, we can be seen in the not dedicate much of the transportation system in the plants. There is a lower form of the plants we can be seen to the plant. So anyhow, they also have a transportation of the system because they can be observed the water and nutrients from the root and they can be the passes to the all the parts of the other body. Yes, they can be related to the transportation system. So not only they can be absorbed our water and also some other nutrients, whatever we have in our body like micronutrients and also macronutrients, that type in the plants also they can be related to the micronutrients and also macronutrients. So like that in the soil generally there will be consist of the some of the particles like iron, molybdenum, manganese, so phosphorus, potassium. So these are the some elements which are present already in the soil. But whatever the root is of the blood should be present in the present that one, they can be observed the water or observe the water along with the these nutrients also. They can be transferred to the all the parts of our all the parts of the plant body. How should be the green be from the blood? So we already know that cell is a structural functional unit of the all the living organism. Either it should be the plant or it should be the animal also. So but in case of plants, only we can be observed in the tissues. So in animals also we can be seen in the tissues, but the tissue we can be seen in the animal tissue means epithelial tissue, columnar tissue, connective tissue, loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, like that we can be observed in the plant. So we want to observe tissues, but plants also only restricted in the tissues. The tissues also perform a definite functions in our body. So like that, plants do not have any organ or organ system. Yes, they should be restricted in the only tissues. So generally you know that any part of the plant which can be grown, so there should be the responsible for the apical meristem which can be delivered to the plant. So apical meristem means whatever growing regions of the plant are there. So maybe in case of the roots or branches of the leaves, or can be seen in the fruits or flowers, whatever you can be observed in the plant, that should be improved for the this one, apical meristem. So all can be called as the other thing can be called as the meristematic tissues. So in meristematic tissues, you can be seen in the this apical meristem, lateral meristem, and also intercalary meristem. So this is the growing region of the any plant part of the body. Either it should be the width of the stem or it should be the length of the plant body. So maybe we should be growing of the roots also they can be responsible for that. So So this is the growing regions. Okay. So next you can be seen into the here you can be seen in the some simple tissues we can be observed in the plants also. So simple tissues means what? So maybe they can be present in the three types of the simple tissues you can divide. So simple tissues means the simple tissue and also they have the complex tissue. So simple tissue means parenchyma, parenchyma and also scleral. So parenchyma means they have the thin walls. So whatever the outer surface of the plants or leaves which are there, they be the cells should be closely related. That one they have the pectin which can be present that of the cells. So cell wall should be thin in the parenchyma. So in case of the parenchyma means so they have the some hard structure compared to the parenchyma. So they have the region in the bark or stem part we can be observed to the parenchyma. So they have to the some of the here we can be seen in the some of the tracheas and vessels. So which can be the pipe-like structures. They can be transferred to the one form to another form. So lastly we can be seen in the sclerenchyma or can be called as the scleroids. So scleroid means nothing but it should be the hard stones like structure. That is it can be called as the sclerenchyma. So it means maybe some of the seeds, maybe if you observe the coconut seeds, so that should the outer part which have to the ground, that is it can be called as the spheroids or it can be called as the sclerenchyma. So if you observe the some of the plants which can be lying in the water also, they have to the some of the thin walls, they will be float on the water, so they will be buoyancy, but that is it can be called as the parenchyma. So why it can be called as the why it can be observed one is because of the transportation is one of the complex process in the plants also, that is it can be present the permanent tissues. So in permanent tissue it can be seen in the two types, that is it can be called as the xylem and phloem. So generally plants absorb the whatever water and minerals are there through the roots like a canals. So they have to the some like a pipe-like structures. So if you observe the straw, so there is a some of the pipe-like structures, they can be arranged in the one to one. So they absorb the these tubes and also they can be passed to the all the parts of the plant body. So especially they have the root hairs. So suppose if you observe in the microscope, so they have to the like this. So the cells should be the arranged in the, so this is can be called the epidermal tissues. So this is can be called the root hairs. So the root hairs which can be observed the water or any other minerals. So through the this pores, so that is we can be called the this epidermal cells. So epidermal cells means they have the maybe only 8 to 10 cells they can be arranged like that one afterwards they can be entered to the vascular bundles. So vascular bundles means here we can be seen in the xylem and phloem. So that is should be the input for the transportation of whatever minerals. So especially we can be called whatever vascular bundles we can be talking about that one. So here the vessels which are made up of this special type of the forming, that is we can be called as the vascular tissue. So tissue means we already know that. So there is a group of cells which perform a definite function, that is we can be called as the tissue. So in plants it can be seen that this xylem and phloem can be seen in the permanent tissue. So this is we can be called as the permanent tissue. So if you observe the how many plants or animals, so there is the very important that one, especially all the plants they will consist of the permanent tissues. So what is the role of the xylem? So xylem is already they will consist of the four vessels. So they consist of the four vessels. So that is you can define as the xylem parenchyma, xylem fibers, xylem tracheids and also vessels you can be called. So these tracheids and vessels they will be input for the transportation of the water and minerals like in channels. So how can be the channel should be the input for the transportation of the water and minerals. So like that they should be also input that one. It forms a continuous network of the channels that connect to the root to stem branches and transfer the entire. So whatever they started in the root, that root to the all the parts of the plant body like in the stem, stem part after the node. If you observe the branches, then transport entire part of the plant, they can be helpful for that one. So all these, they can be transported, means they will be only these vessels. So whatever you may call them, xylem trachees and the vessels. So lastly, xylem parenchyma and xylem nucleus. These four should be the helpful to the all the water and minerals out there. That should be transported to the all the part of the plants of the body. So if you observe the problem, so when we use the straw for the coconut, it can be observed that, right? So like that, the water should be also transferred to the opposition of the gravitational force, hence it is known as the xyla tissues. So next one is phloem. So like that water, xylem also, phloem should be the one of the food conductive tissue, it can be called the food conductive tissue. So whatever the plants which can be prepared, they want food with the help of sunlight, water, carbon dioxide and other minerals, so they can be stored in the form of the food, or we can regard as the glucose, whatever we can regard as the glucose or carbohydrate form. So that should be the transport to the all the parts of the body. The food which can be the transport to the all the parts of the plant part, that is, it can be called as the phloem, or any other process it can be called as, that is, the translocation, it can be called the phloem. So generally we know that the leaves which can be synthesized, they put the transport to all the parts of the plant body, is it? So this is done by the respiratory tissue, it can be called as the phloem. So here also we can be questioning the phloem parenchyma, phloem fibers. So like that also you can be seen in the tissues. So these phloem should be the helpful for the translocation of the substances from the all the parts of the plant. Especially if you see the any plant, they can be done with the any seed into converted into fruit or leaf, fruit or flower, which are the plant. So that is the we can be called the fruit of the plant, is it? So that should be the transport to all the parts of the plant body in the this. So it is also consist of the phloem parenchyma, phloem fibers. So like that we can be observed. So these two permanent tissues which can be the transportation of the plants in the plant body. So this is the one of the role of the water and minerals and also food. How can be the transportation in the food, transportation in the plants, is it? So next, if you come across to the transpiration. So what is the meaning of the transpiration? So generally in summer season, what happens in our body? So we can sweat, is it? So why do we need to sweat? Means whatever unwanted particles are there, especially salt or nitrogenous or sweat glands which are present there, right? They can be the remove the water from our plant body. So excess or temperature, whatever there in our body, they can be the observed of that one, is it? So our body should be the again, they can be converted into cool, yes, we can be sweating, is it? So like that, in plants also, when the water should be the very high, or the water should be the increases, whatever it may be in the water, that water should be the very high in the plants. So generally what happens, all the water cannot be, they can be the absorbed to that one, is it? So excess water they can be absorbed, but whatever absorbed all the water that cannot be utilized for their life process. So yes, some amount of the water should be the loss, or they can be the transpiration, it can be called that one. So they can be lost the water from their body, yes, it can be called as the transpiration. So transpiration means it is the process of the releasing of the water. So generally we know that the plants which can be consist of the some stomata in their pores, is it? That stomata means which can be the tiny pores which are present on the leaves, that is the, you can be called as the stomata. That stomata should be also helpful for the respiration, and also they can be the, not only for the respiration, and also they can be helpful for the loss of water also. So the loss of water means the water which can be the removed from the plant, or they can be the they can be lost their water in the form of the water droplets. So that is it can be called as the transpiration. So why do we need this means? Why do we need this means? So the whatever the excess of water is there, that should be the last update from the body. So especially whatever the desert plants we can be seen, so they are generally they do not have any water. They also lost their water in the form of the river. So the excess water which are there may be stored in the stem part. So especially we can be seen in the some of the desert plants we can be observed the tar like plants we can be observed the So this is the transpiration in plants. So transpiration means nothing but the plants which can be lost their water by the stomata part of this we can be called as the transpiration. So transpiration means so the hole should be there, we can be with the help of the straw we can be observed the water from the any glass vessel like that it should be we can be seen in the plants also. So this is also one of the natural phenomena of all the plants we can be observed that one. So dear students, once again we can be summarize the discussion means. So here we can be discuss about the what is the meaning of the transportation. So what is the role of the transportation in animals like blood vessels, and also lastly we can be discuss about the heart. So in today's class we can be discuss about the transportation in plants. Here we can be discuss about the xylem and phloem. How should be that this xylem and phloem should be the responsible for the transportation of the water and minerals. So lastly we can discuss about the transportation. Thank you and all.